I'm back at Costco, and this time is to make a deep review of the best vegan and non-vegan protein powders. So at home, we are not really fans of protein powders because, as you always hear me, I'm a fan of whole foods, whatever is coming from the ground, whatever is coming from the ocean. And my question for you is, do you see a protein powder growing from the ground? No, right? So that means there's a lot of stuff that happens in between. It can be really processed. But still, my husband sometimes wants his protein powder, but at the end up being expired on the shelf because it tasted really artificial. But a lot of you love protein powders, and it's one of the main questions that I get. Which is a good protein powder out there? Because it's convenient, right? It's something that you just shake and you take it with you for pre-workout, post-workout, as a replacement meal. So it's why we are gonna enter in Costco right now, and we are going to see what are the best or the wrong options out there. Alright, so we got to the area of the protein powders. Let's start reviewing what we see first. So let's start with a non-vegan protein powder. This is a very common one. The people, when they go into non-vegan protein powders, they tend to buy whey protein powder. And how do we have to read the label for this? So let's see what we find. So we have whey protein isolate and whey protein concentrate. On an anti-inflammatory diet, I recommend to avoid dairy because dairy is casein in dairy is a very complex protein that if you suffer from gastrointestinal inflammation, you are not gonna digest. So it gets fermented and becomes one of the most dangerous toxins circulating around your body and cause an inflammatory response. Plus casein induces a bioactive opioid that causes addiction. So that's why we love dairy products. But the difference between whey isolate and whey protein isolate and whey protein concentrate, when you see a whey protein concentrate, that means you have whey protein plus everything else that is inside milk. So it's an accumulation of a lot of the proteins, sugars, a lot of the molecules that we find in dairy. However, whey protein isolate is what you want to look for. Isolate means you only have whey protein. You don't have any other contamination with any other molecules from the milk. No casein, no lactose, nothing that is causing inflammation. So here we'll have as a second ingredient whey protein concentrate, which is not ideal. Plus, it has cocoa alkali. Natural and artificial flavors. So of course, you don't want to have artificial flavors, but natural flavors is more or less the same because there are more than 100 different type of ingredients included in natural flavors that we don't even know what they are. Some of them are synthetic and are also very toxic. Like for example, MSG is also included in natural flavors. So ideally, we don't want to find this in there. And then we have creamer, and where is the creamer? Maltodextrin is an added sugar. Sunflower oil is a refined oil. Then you have food starch, which is another added sugar, plus additives that your digestive system cannot break down and cause more inflammation, plus more sugar in the form of sucralose and lactose. So basically you have like 4 to 5 different type of sugar on this product, so I wouldn't go for it. And also what it means, cocoa processed with alkali, the word already says process. So what it means is that they have already modified the raw cacao. Raw cacao is a superfood and it's full of minerals and anandamide and tryptophan, a lot of good things for your body. However, when they process it with alkali, they deplete a lot of those minerals. So you are basically, this is just to add the flavor of chocolate, but you don't have a lot of the benefits in there. So I'm gonna put this back. Oh, and I forgot to mention that in here it says no artificial growth hormones, which is important. But if you are going to buy a whey that is coming from an animal, what is important is to find from grass fed. So that's what you have to look for. Not just non-hormones is not ideal.
You want to see grass-fed whey protein isolate. So let's see what we have next in here. All right, this is also a very common form of protein powder that I see that a lot of people buy. This is, it says, this is non-vegan. It says non-artificial growth hormones. I don't see anywhere the label for grass-fed, but let's see what the label says. You have a protein blend that is whey protein concentrate and whey protein isolate. Hydrolyzed means that they make it more digestible, which is a good thing. But the main ingredient, the first ingredient here, is concentrate. So you have more of whey protein concentrate than isolate. And we said that the one we want to see is just isolate. You have a lot of contamination with milk here. Then you have cacao bean powder. It's non-processed, so it's good. Again, natural and artificial flavor. This is something that ideally you don't want to. Inulin is a fiber. I will talk about that. Now, they add sucralose. This is a bummer. So they add one of the 61 different names for sugar. Plus, they add amino acids, which is not a must because already this is a protein powder. So you don't need to bulk up the protein powder with more amino acids. But what is inulin? So inulin is an indigestive fiber that is gonna feed the bacteria in your gut. So if you have really good gut health and you have a lot of beneficial bacteria, that is a really good prebiotic that is feeding the good bacteria. But if you do have gut inflammation and dysbiosis and bacteria overgrowth, like for example SIBO, then you are also feeding the opportunistic bacteria. So which means when you eat something with inulin, you are gonna get bloated and you are not gonna feel good and you are gonna cause more bacteria overgrowth. So that's why ideally inulin only if you know that your digestive system is working well. But this one, I will say no. Again, it has added sugars and it has whey protein concentrate. It's not just isolate. All right, so let's see this one, amino energy. All right, so what are the ingredients in here? So we have citric acid, which ideally that's an additive that you don't want to see, that causes a lot of gastrointestinal distress. Again, natural and artificial flavors, and it's the second ingredient, which means you have a lot of them in there. Silicon dioxide, calcium, xanthan gum. That is okay. Xanthan gum is a fermentation of sugars by Xanthomonas campestris. If it's not in high amounts, it's okay. But what I don't really like is carrageenan. Carrageenan, they added to make it thicker. And carrageenan is carcinogenic, so you don't want to see carrageenan anywhere. Sucralose, added sugar, and contains soy, definitely. When it says lecithin, you don't know if it's coming from soy or other seeds, always go in what contains. But clearly here they say soy, and this tends to cause a lot of gastrointestinal distress. So let's see other protein powder that is also very popular here. It's a chocolate flavor, 20 grams of protein. So these are mostly protein powders. What we have? Ooh, this is a huge list of things. When I see already so many ingredients, sometimes I don't even read it. But then we have milk protein isolate, but we don't know if that is whey, which kind of milk protein isolate, so we don't know. Yeah, it has a lot of milk contamination, so this is gonna cause a lot of gastrointestinal distress. Again, alkalized cocoa powder, which means they have processed the cacao, eliminating a lot of minerals, so it's basically to add flavor. Yeah, gums, potassium chloride, carrageenan again. We said this is carcinogenic. You don't want to add it. This just is just to make it thicker. Canola oil. Canola oil is one of the most important hydrogenated oils to avoid. It's isolated with petroleum. The same for sunflower oil. So you have two in a row. Plus dead sugar, I mean, I'm not gonna continue. This is already a huge list of ingredients. Plus again, what we see is free of hormones, but we don't see if it's a grass-fed cow. Let's see if we find another option for a non-vegan that is better. Oh, this one is also very popular. There is in chocolate form and vanilla form, 30 grams of protein, no hormones added. All right, so what we see here, milk protein concentrate. Again, this is not an isolated form of whey, so there is a lot of contamination with other molecules of the dairy, so that's gonna cause a lot of gastrointestinal distress. I don't really usually like the sources of sunflower oil. Oleic acid is in a lot of oils, and this is a really good antioxidant, anti-inflammatory compound in oils, but I don't like the source from sunflower oil because usually this is refined. Again, natural and artificial flavors. Inulin, which is a good fiber if your gut is in a good shape. Then they add sucralose, they add carrageenan, which is carcinogenic. So yeah, this has a lot of things again. So I didn't find really a good protein powder that is non-vegan so far in here. Let's see this one for kids. Let's see, we wanna give this to your kids. Organ is usually a really good brand. They take care of a lot of things. It says that it has less sugar, which is good. Fiber, vitamin, minerals, chocolate flavor. Look at this. This is a plus. Organic grass-fed protein. We don't know if it's grass-fed finish, which is the ideal, but this is already better. So grass-fed protein, no artificial colorings. All right, so this is promising. Let's see ingredients. So we see grass-fed milk protein concentrate, and then they have whey protein concentrate. So I would say that ideally they want to have grass-fed whey protein isolate. There are a lot of proteins in here. The source is clean and it's non-GMO as well, so this is pretty good. But ideally, just in case the kid has gastrointestinal distress, I would say to avoid it. But then they add dextrin, which is another sugar. Cane sugar is another added sugar. Brown rice syrup is another added sugar. Then inulin is a good fiber if the kid doesn't have gastrointestinal distress. Cocoa powder is already processed. Natural flavors. It said on the front, no additives, but on this natural flavor, there are additives. If you want to have sometimes something to give to your kids, at least the source is clean, but you have added sugars in here, and this may cause some gastrointestinal distress and permeability. So not 100% bad choice, but some things in the ingredients that we don't like. And then the same here for another organ as well that says grass-fed. So this one is the same, but not for kids, but promising grass-fed protein, which is good. No carrageenan, that's perfect. No artificial sweeteners. It has less ingredients than the one for kids, that's for sure. Again, here we have grass-fed milk protein concentrate. So you want to avoid dairy. This is not ideal because it's not just whey protein isolate. Then agave, cocoa powder is not processed cocoa powder, so that's good. Again, sunflower oil, which is not my favorite, but at least it's just probably the isolated form of oleic acid, which is good. And then, yeah, monk fruit extract, so that's good. They don't add any other artificial sweeteners. Stevia, so that's also good. So if you tolerate dairy, this is not that bad. However, what do I have to say about agave nectar? That is a sweetener very high in the ingredients order. So agave nectar, you have to be careful with it because it's natural, but it's pure fructose. And what happens with fructose goes directly to your liver. Is not really spiking any hormone, just goes to the liver and is metabolized into triglycerides and cholesterol. So too much fructose can cause fatty liver. So it's why I usually say try to avoid agave. So again, this one is not 100% clean, but cleaner than others that we have seen. Oh, here we go. This is another one very popular that people ask me about. It has 16 grams of protein, less than the other ones. No artificial growth hormones. water, then corn maltodextrin. That's almost the first ingredient. That's an added sugar, plus the added sugar. It's milk protein concentrate. It's not the isolated form of whey protein. So that means it's an O. Plus they have canola and corn oil in here. Canola and corn oil are the oils that are refined with petroleum and a lot of chemicals. Soy protein. Soy causes a lot of gastrointestinal inflammation. So basically, I cannot really tell any good ingredient on this shake. So no luck so far. We didn't get any protein powder that we like. So let's, before we go to the plant-based protein powders, let's see if there is anything else that we can get. All right, so here it is. This is a really good product that I have to say is good, that Costco that brought it. Now there is a new option. There is in chocolate flavor, or there is also plain, if you don't like to add any flavor. So what is this? So here it says grass-fed pasture raised. This is great. This is what we want to look for. And then basically the ingredient for this is just collagen powder, collagen peptides. You don't have any other ingredients in there. So collagen peptides is a great way to help boosting your immunity, also balancing your gut. This is really good for healing the gut lining, for preventing gastrointestinal inflammation. So collagen is something that you want to put in your diet if you are not drinking bone broth every day, or I'm drinking the broth, but I also put collagen on top of my food or my drinks every day. And but just to be aware, this is not a complete protein if you are looking for a protein powder, but it's a really good addition to other proteins that you may have also in your meal. So I think this one is gonna go home. It's really clean. It's just collagen peptides and it's grass-fed and pasture-raised. But let's see the chocolate. If they are adding any extra ingredients in the chocolate. So it's cocoa powder, natural flavors. That the part I don't really like already. Salt and stevia. So the stevia good. Cacao that is not processed as well, but be aware that you have a little bit of natural flavors already there that you don't have in the plain. So I'm gonna take the plain, and then what you can do is just mix the plain with cacao powder and stevia, and that's it. You will do the same, or the plain with some vanilla extract, and that will be your vanilla flavor. We can always play with food around. And then let's start checking some plant-based proteins about this. So here we have a shake that is already pre-made. Again, Orgain's usually a very good brand. This is 20 grams. It's plant-based and it's non-GMO, so this is already a plus. So it says no carrageenan or artificial flavors. That's good. Pea protein. Usually vegan protein powders are pea protein based. So pea protein is okay, but it doesn't say organic pea protein, and it's essential that pea protein is organic. Organic alkalized cocoa, so I'm surprised that everything is organic. Like organic cacao, which is already processed, you have natural flavors, so not completely clean. You have monk fruit, and then it says organic fruits and vegetable blend. Fiber, acai, beets, kale, so this is all good and it's organic. But then the pea protein, which is the main protein in here, is non-organic, and this is very important. So something that I have to say about pea protein is that pea protein is really high in purines. So if you are a person that suffers from gout, ideally you want to avoid having too many purines, and pea protein is very high in purines. Pea protein usually is not a big allergen, like for example, peanuts is one of the biggest allergens. So it's okay, but some people still have some food allergies or gastrointestinal inflammation with peas, but mostly if they have pesticides. So what you have to look for the pea protein is that says not just non-GMO, but says organic. That is very important. And why pea protein is also a really good plant-based protein if it's organic is because it has all the amino acids that are important for building protein in your body. It has essential and non-essential amino acids. And some of those amino acids are really good for digestive health, like, for example, lysine, arginine, glutamine. Those are in pea protein, so it's good. And it's a starch that is not spiking your insulin that much. So this one is not organic, so then it's not my favorite. Let's pass to the next plant-based protein powder. Let's see what we have. Okay, so here there is another organ protein powder that is plant-based. So this one says organic, which is good, plant-based. When we talk about plant-based protein powders, always organic-based, no pesticides. And it says probiotic. So let's see what the ingredient label says. So organic pea protein, this is good. We said that we want pea protein to be organic. So that's good. Organic brown rice powder. And it's brown rice, so it has the fiber in there. So that's balancing blood sugar. Chia seeds, organic as well. That is a really, really good protein. And then it has acacia, is a fiber. High oleic acid, which is isolated from sunflower, not too bad. But then rice dextrin, that is another sugar that I don't like. Erythritol is a sugar alcohol. Cacao that is already modified. All right. And then bacillus. So I don't think this protein powder is completely bad because it's organic pea protein, but it has some erythritol in there that is a sugar alcohol. And you know what I think about sugar alcohols? They don't get digested in the digestive tract and they cause a lot of gastrointestinal distress. So this is the part that I don't really like, but the rest is not too bad. So this will be an option that you can put in your cart. At least doesn't have any natural flavors. Here, Organ has another one that is peanut butter cup flavor for the peanut butter cup lovers. Organic pea protein, that's great. It has peanut flour, which peanuts is one of the highest allergens out there that can cause a lot of allergies. I would say even if they are organic, try to avoid peanuts. Pumpkin seeds is good, almond powder, chia, coconut sugar is not that bad, but they're raising your insulin a little bit more. And then the natural flavor. So if I had to pick one, I would go for the other one instead of this. And look at this, this is something new that I see here. This is not really a protein powder, but maybe it could be a good nutritional addition to your, if you don't have enough fruit or vegetable intake, to boost your immunity. So let's see what it says. Oh, a lot of ingredients, but it has a lot of everything organic. Cinnamon, balanced blood sugar. It has buckwheat, quinoa, chia, millet, amaranth. Those are gluten-free grains and they are organic. It has quinoa sprouts. Actually, all of this is sprout, it is it. Sprout blend. Amaranth sprout, quinoa sprout, millet sprout, buckwheat sprout. Sprouts are pre-digested, so that is a really good thing for your gut. Cranberry, wheatgrass. This is a bunch of a lot of good superfoods. And I'm trying to catch any other sugar in there, but I don't really see any. Oh, I see natural flavors in here, which I don't like it. Yeah, it has adaptogens. It has mushroom powder, ashwagandha. This is not bad. It's non-GMO. It's organic. It's a bunch of superfoods. Just a little bit of natural flavors in there, which I don't really like them. That's not 100% clean, but not really, really bad. So I see here another organ protein powder that they call it superfood. Let's see how it is. Okay, so we have here superfood protein powder that's promising. Oh, a lot of ingredients I see here. So pea protein, it says organic protein blend. That's organic. Rice protein, pea protein, chia. It's not bad. Then acai. Rice dextrin is another sugar, erythritol, that is a sugar alcohol, natural flavors. We said we don't want to have natural flavors. The same blend that we get in the immune booster. So it's not extremely dirty if you want to give a try to this, but remember there are some sugar alcohols, a few of natural flavors in there, and then some gluten-free grains that may cause some inflammation, and millet has been shown to affect thyroid function. So I hope you now learn how you can start reading labels for protein powders. As you can see, there are not many out there. Better to stick to the whole food. So check my video of how to make your own protein powder from whole foods, vegan or non-vegan. It's in the description of the video as well, or on a link around here. And if you want me to review any other product in here, just put it in the comment section so we can make a video about it. So I hope you stay hanging out in here, checking more videos for grocery haul, and I hope to see you in the next video.